My name is Alan Hawes. I'm Vice President of Technical Staff for Solutions and Software at Cypress Semiconductor. I hope you're learning a lot from this video series on PSoC BLE. In this lesson, we will take the Find Me profile you built in the first two lessons and add a battery level service. This is a very common thing to do because most Bluetooth low energy devices are battery powered, often with just a CR2032 coin cell. Starting with our Find Me design, I need to open the BLE component customizer and edit the profile to include the new battery service. In the Profile tab, select the Find Me target and press the Add Service button. Pick out Battery from the list, and it gets added automatically to the profile. The battery service is one of the many services defined by the BLE SIG. It's also supported for you by PSoC Creator with firmware that's built into the component. Now, let's initialize the reported level of the battery level characteristic. Under the battery service is a characteristic called battery level. Clicking on it reveals the details of the characteristic, and as the level is percentage, it makes sense that we should start with a value of 100 to signify a full battery. That's all we need to do. Just build and program the target. When I connect the device from CY Smart on my phone, I can see the new service with the battery level at 100%. Hey, that's pretty cool. This demonstrates how easy it is to add the service. We didn't even write a single line of code because the stack handled everything for us. Though, I have to admit, it's kind of boring because it always reports 100%. So let's change that. Normally, you would use a resistor divider network to create a sensing node to measure the battery with the analog to digital converter. But as that node doesn't exist on the Pioneer board, I'm going to create a synthetic measurement and show you how to update the GAT database with new data. Basically, I'll use a timer to reduce the battery level by 1% every second. First of all, let's add a timer that will generate an interrupt once every second. I'm using the TCPWM-based timer that I've shown you before. Connect a clock component to the input and change its frequency to the kilohertz range with a value of 12. In the timer, choose a period of 12,000 and make sure you check the TC interrupt. This will cause the timer to generate an interrupt when it reaches zero, once per second. Finally, attach an ISR component and give it a friendly name. In this case, Timer ISR. In the main.c, I have to start the timer and install an interrupt handler. Moving back up the file, I'll write the ISR by using the CY ISR macro. I'll clear the interrupt and then update the battery level. The level is stored inside of the GAT database, which we extended to include the characteristic of the battery level service. I'm going to read the characteristic, modify the level, and then write it back into the database. Remember, the GAT server in your implementation will automatically provide the information to the GAT client on the other end of the connection. First, I create two local variables, one for the level, and one with the appropriate GAT data structure. In this case, it's CYBLE GAT handle value pair underscore T, and I initialize it. Remember, all of these data structures can be found in the online API browser, which we talked about in the earlier lesson. Then I call the CYBLE GAT S read attribute value API to extract the information. Yes, I know that's a handful. I just had to say it. But it's important to understand. GAT S part of the API tells you that it is part of the GAT server. Next, I modify the battery level by decrementing it 1%. Then when it reaches 0%, I put it back to 100%. This will give us a characteristic that will change often enough to be interesting. In a real world, You would replace this synthetic measurement with a real battery measurement. Finally, I just have to update the database. So I use the complement to the read attribute API. To do that, you use a CYBLE GAT S write instead of read. Then I'll build and program the kit just as I've been doing in all of the other examples. As usual, I will test the new updates using CY Smart. You can see that every time I read the battery level, it's changed by 1%. I've been using CY Smart on the phone so far, but we also have a PC-based version. It gives you a lot more detail than the phone-based app. With this tool, you can browse into the GAT database. To do this, first start CY Smart. Then you select the Cypress BLE dongle and press Connect. Then you press Start Scan to see what devices are out there in advertising. When you see a device that you're interested in, select it and then press Connect. Then you press Discover All Attributes. CY Smart will then interrogate the GAT server that you just connected to. It will look through the database and it will create a copy inside of CY Smart of exactly what you configured in your peripheral. Now you click on the alert level characteristic. Then you can type in a new value, either a 0 or a 1 or a 2, representing the three alert levels. Once you've selected the number you want, click the write with no response. Notice that if you write a 1, the LED will start blinking. Each of the profiles, services, and characteristics that you defined in the component customizer are available in CY Smart. If you have configured them to be writable, then you can write them. If you configured them to be readable, then you can read them. Now we have extended our application by including a battery level service. We have now seen applications where the phone sends data to the peripheral with a write and where it reads data from the peripheral with a read. See if you can replicate this in your own design. As always, you're welcome to email me at alan_hawes@cypress.com with your comments, suggestions, criticisms, and questions. Thank you.